from New York, loose scaffolding and manholes mean bigger savings for you. It's Late Night with David Letterman. Tonight, Damon Wayans, singer Nick Cave, and from the Philadelphia Phillies, all-star first baseman John Crook. And now the man in charge of keeping the French athlete sober, David Letterman.
Much for being here, ladies and gentlemen. I was coming into the studio and I heard this on the radio. Prison officials now in Connecticut believe that the hotel queen Leona Helmsley, who's presently doing time, they have reason to believe now that this woman, while she's serving her jail time, is paying another inmate to do her laundry and also to make her bed. And today, prison officials conducted a cell-to-cell pillow chocolate search. Pillow mint search. Cell to cell search for pillow mints. There. Conducted a cell to cell search for pillow mints. There. Pillow chocolate, pillow mints. Ladies and gentlemen, former undeclared presidential candidate Ross Perot has signed a multi-million dollar deal to write a book. And in the book, he's going to outline what he believes would be solutions and plans to improve this country. Gee, I hope he doesn't quit writing it halfway through, because that would really be... How disappointing would that be? Down in Washington earlier today, our Vice President Dan Quayle went over to the Department of the Interior and added his name to the endangered species list. I don't know. Exactly, does that mean? Yeah. Yesterday, our President George Bush said that absolutely will he not dump Dan Quayle. He said, with beyond a shadow of a doubt, he said, he is my vice president and he's going to stay on the ticket and I don't care what happens. Now, on the bright side, President Bush has lied to us before, so you never just never really know. Hello, girls. Where are they? Hello. Ladies and gentlemen, I believe we have a pretty good show. Damon Wayans is here from the television program In Living Color, and also the last Boy Scout. And his brand new film, Mo Money. Damon Wayans is here. Musician Nick Cave will be here. And from the Philadelphia Phillies, we have all-star first baseman John Crook. Now, here's our friend Paul Schaefer, ladies and gentlemen.
Hi, boys. Damon, hello. Hi, everybody. Ah, boy.
Hi, Bailey.
Hey, Dave, you know, I've been making an in-depth study of the election campaigns thus far, and I have come up with something that I think is quite important, the way I feel, at least to me it's important, about my feelings towards all the candidates, and that is, I think they're all marvelous. So that is what I have come up with, and I want to thank you for giving me that opportunity.
Is there something wrong with this jacket? Does it look like there's something wrong with this jacket? It's just, I don't know, it looks like it's made of space-age polymers. What? Thank you very much. Why, thank you, girls. It looks like it's made of carbon fiber, doesn't it?
Well,
or is it the color, or is it just that I don't have the body for this jacket? Can you tell I've cut back on the steroids? About 6 weeks ago, we had a little demonstration, a little contest, and what we did was we selected a brand new slogan for the Republican Party. Do you remember that, Paul?
I remember that.
Long before the Democrats had their convention, long before things really started to heat up, and it was before Ross Perot dropped out. Do you remember the slogan we selected?
Well, no,
it was deficit schmeficit.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Deficit schmeficit.
Deficit,
I remember it well.
Schmeficit. And we had somebody from the committee to reelect the president on the line, and we called her right up and said, okay, here's the slogan, and if you use it, you don't owe us a thing, but it's deficit schmeficit, and she really wasn't interested.
Yeah.
Well, tonight, we're going to do the same thing for the Democrats. We're going to select a campaign slogan. They have, of course, Clinton, and they have Al Gore. That represents the ticket. We're going to pick out a new slogan for those folks, and then we'll see if they're interested in using it. And on the line, I have with me here tonight, blinking on the line, is Dee Dee Myers. Dee Dee is the campaign press secretary, Clinton Gore National Campaign Headquarters in Little Rock, Arkansas. Let me see if this will be her.
Hello, Dee Dee.
Hi.
1 minute for Mr. Letterman, please.
Okay. Hi, Dee Dee. This is Dave.
Hey, Dave.
Dee Dee, how are you?
I'm terrific, Dave. How are you?
Great. Dee Dee, do me a favor, in a sentence or two, if you can, describe for us the excitement of the Democratic juggernaut after that great convention here in New York City.
It was wild. It was great fun. We went from New York to New Jersey to Pennsylvania, West Virginia,
this was all
Ohio,
on that bus,
Kentucky,
wasn't it?
Missouri. We had a great time. Indiana, can't forget Indiana.
This was all on the bus.
We had six buses.
You had six buses.
It was a big bus cade.
Wow, so you really were going first class then.
We moved up and got onto the bus.
Now, Dee Dee, do you know why we're talking to you tonight?
No, I know you're looking for Governor Clinton.
That's right. We have a slogan which we think might be suitable for your campaign.
We're in the market for slogans.
All right, we're going to select a new one for you here tonight. Now, where is the governor right now?
He's in Houston, Texas.
Okay, here's what I want you to do, Dee Dee. Get on one of those buses. See if you can't get a hold of the governor for us, and then when we select the slogan, we'll tell it to him here on the phone, okay?
Well, are you guys willing to hang on? We're trying to get a hold of him.
Yeah, okay, we're going to hang on. We haven't picked the slogan yet.
Okay, so...
And then when we pick the slogan, we'll... Okay, all right, now, when you call back, if you can't get a hold of me, ask for my assistant, Debbie, all right?
Okay, will do.
That was Debbie you spoke to on the phone earlier. Okay, I'm going to put you on hold.
Okay, thanks.
All right, good luck, Dee Dee.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Okay, all right, so that's Dee Dee. Now, all we have to do is select a new slogan. We're going to have folks come out here, and you can, I guess I'll choose the new slogan.
Go ahead.
Right? Okay, here we go. All right, is everybody ready back there for the new Democratic campaign slogan? Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Here is our first slogan for your consideration. Come on in, please, and here we go. Slogan number one.
Look, no Dukakis.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Slogan number one for your consideration. Look. No Dukakis. You know, that's the problem with this jacket. There's just no Dukakis in there. Look at that.
Yeah.
Why couldn't they put a little Dukakis in this thing, for heaven's sakes? Then you get a jacket. Slogan number two. Here we go. Come on out, please, and let's hear slogan number two.
Hey, we got a bus!
All right, there you go. Slogan number two. Hey, we got a bus. All right. Next, slogan number three. Here we go.
Oh, my.
Yeah.
Bottoms up, Clintaholics.
That's my favorite.
There you go.
And there's a dress with Dukakis.
Right there.
All right, our next slogan, please. Come on out and announce the slogan for us. Okay, how do you do, ma'am? Our fourth slogan under consideration here tonight.
We don't have a clue, but we don't have a quail.
There you go. We don't have a clue, but we don't have a quail. All right. We have one more slogan for you to listen to here tonight, and then we'll pick one and shoot it off to the Democrats. Come on out, please, sir, if you will. This is our final slogan of the evening for consideration for the Democratic candidacy. Here we go.
We've got pictures of Bush with Angela Lansbury.
Okay. Now, let's take a second here now to review the slogans under consideration. Number one.
Look, no Dukakis.
That's right. Number two.
Hey, we got a bus.
Number two is, hey, we got a bus. Number three.
Bottoms up, Clintaholics.
Oh, my, sir. Number four.
We don't have a clue, but we don't have a quail.
Yeah, okay. And finally, number five. Here we go.
We've got pictures of Bush with Angela Lansbury.
All right. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, I've made my decision, and I believe we're going to have to go with we don't have a clue, but we don't have a quail. Congratulations. You're a winner. Thanks. I appreciate your help. Nice to have you here. Always a pleasure to have you with us. Thank you very much. Nice to see you. Bye-bye. Good luck on the bus. Latika, good to have you with us again. Thank you very much for being here. Bye-bye. All right, come right over here and have a seat. So once again, what was the slogan?
We don't have a clue, but we don't have a quail.
There you go. All right, now we have the governor here on the line? The middle line, or they're both blinking, which is the middle one? Come here and point to the governor for me. I don't care.
Hello, is this the governor?
Yes.
Oh, I'll get Dave, hang on.
Sounded like the governor. Hello?
Hey.
Who is this? Hello? Hello? Going pretty well, isn't it? They don't have a clue. Where did he go now? Huh? Is that him there? Hello?
Hi, Dave.
Hi, Dee Dee. How are you?
I'm great.
I think the governor just hung up on us.
Oh, seriously?
Yeah, I think I was startled.
Jeez, what, you guys didn't come up with a good slogan?
No, it's not our fault, Dee Dee. No, hey, now wait a minute.
We're counting on you.
No, we have a great slogan. Oh, wait a minute. Is the governor back on here? All right, Dee Dee, I'm going to put you. No, his light just went out again. All right, we'll wait for just one more second. Do we think that was Governor Clinton?
Can you give me any clues about the slogan while I'm waiting?
It's a great. It's a wonderful slogan, and I think it's going to turn this thing, instead of a horse race, it's going to be a landslide.
Landslide.
There you go. Can somebody help me out here with the possibility of talking to the governor? Well, I knew that. That's no help at all. I asked our producer, can I have some help on this? And he says, as soon as he calls in, you can talk to him then. Attaboy, Bob. I don't know what to do. I just honestly... Okay, well, I'm going to tell you the slogan, Dee Dee, and then we're going to try and get the governor back on, okay?
Okay.
Okay, here is the one. One of the slogans was, look, no Dukakis. the other one was, hey, we got a bus. And then we had Bottoms Up, Clintaholics, my personal favorite. And we've got pictures of Bush with Angela Lansbury. That did very well. Huh? Now what? Now you have the governor. No, you don't. Thank you, Curly. Thank you, Mo. And, of course, my best to Larry. Is the governor there or not? Okay, Dee Dee, we think the governor's on the phone.
Oh, good.
Okay, hang on a second. I'm going to put you on hold.
Terrific.
Dee Dee, if something happens and we don't talk again, you know I love you.
I love you, too.
Okay, bye-bye. Right. Hello, is this the governor?
It is. How are you?
Oh, it's Governor Bill. Very exciting, isn't it? Governor, how are things going down there in Houston?
They're going great. You should have been on the road with us.
Yeah, what was that like?
Well, you could have had 10 reasons to do it and 10 reasons not to do it.
Yeah?
I mean, it would have been hilarious.
And were people actually showering on the bus, Governor?
No showers on the bus except when the water splattered up in your face.
Yeah. Well, that sounds like a great deal of fun.
Bathrooms didn't always work. I thought of you then. That would be one of your negative reasons.
What are you doing down there in Texas now?
I came down to meet with the mayor and the police in Houston to emphasize that one of their programs, they've actually made the crime rate go down here, and I wanted America to know about it and say we can do it everywhere.
Yeah, good for you. And give them my best. I know they're doing a wonderful job, and tell them I'll be down there as soon as I can.
You need to get on this bus tour.
Governor, we have here for you now, we have a slogan that we think you can successfully incorporate into your campaign, and we've tested it in front of 300 people here in the studio audience, and I think it's the kind of thing that will crush the opposition.
Lay it on me.
All right. Hey, what? By the way, what do you think of that Perot deal? What the hell's going on there?
I don't know.
There's some insight. Governor, all right, here's the slogan. You want to do the slogan for me?
All right.
All right. I'm going to turn you over to the woman who brought the slogan to us tonight, okay? Governor?
Yep.
Okay. Oh, he's getting pissed. There you go. Okay, say hello to the governor.
Hello, governor.
Hi, what's your name?
Constance.
Where are you from, Constance?
And I'm so glad to speak to you.
Oh, I'm glad to speak to you. Where are you from?
New York.
Good.
And very enthused about you.
Is Letterman behaving tonight?
Oh, very beautifully, as usual.
As usual.
So this is my slogan for you, governor.
Okay.
We don't have a clue, but we don't have a quail.
Nicely done. Very, very nice, thank you. There you go, Governor. Good luck to you. Thanks for your time, sir.
Thanks, David.
All righty, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
There you go. And then we'll be back here with Damon Wayne. Just joining us, we talked with Governor Bill Clinton on the telephone a few minutes ago. That was a lot of fun. Very
great.
Nice. He was a very busy man. What I liked about that is when it was time for the dirty work, I handed it right over to Constance. Oh, here you go. She has the slogan, Governor.
I noticed that.
And thank God we didn't have to listen to that saxophone. I was worried that he'd have the saxophone with him.
I think he was wearing the shades, though, as he was
probably
talking to
so.
Us. Had the shades.
Let's see. Damon Wayans is here. Nick Cave is here. John Kruk, interesting man, first baseman for the Philadelphia Phillies down there in Philadelphia is where they play. Let's do the list, the top 10 list. Do we have time for this? We're desperately late because of a telephone screw-up.
Terrible.
I inadvertently disconnected the governor, and then he was stunned, and we couldn't get him back, and now everything is fine now. Although I'm not taking responsibility for that in the meeting. Here we go. The category tonight, top 10 signs you've gone to a bad hypnotist.
All right.
Signs now that you've gone to a bad hypnotist. I think one sign would be you show up on television wearing a jacket that looks like this. It looks like some sort of kryptonite metal, doesn't it? Some sort of alloy from Neptune. Top 10 signs you've gone to a bad hypnotist. Number 10, when you come to, he's wearing your clothes. Number 9, you now own 19 Juice Tigers. Number 8, days after your appointment, strangers come up to you on the street saying how much they enjoyed you in that live sex show. Number 7, number 7, everywhere you look, giant whistling squirrels. Number 6, he tells you your wallet is blocking the alpha rays. Better let him hold it. Number 5, he says you're getting very slippery. No, that's not it. Number 4, anytime someone says the word hello, you find yourself naked in Syracuse. Number 3, Suddenly you remember him from shop class. Number two, instead of tapping into your subconscious, he just waits for you to doze off and then yells at you. And the number one sign you've gone to a bad hypnotist, you wake up married to Doug Henning. Well, there you go. Let's bring out our first guest and then get the program going. What do you say?
Sounds like a good idea.
Bring out the first guest and get the program going.
Now you're talking my language.
I'll need your undivided attention for the remainder of the show.
You got it, baby.
Our first guest is the best known for his work on the Fox series In Living Color. Now this man has written, produced, and stars in a brand new film entitled Mo Money, which opens Friday. Ladies and gentlemen, here's Damon Wayans. Damon!
Network talk show host.
Go ahead, boy, grab him. Don't be a baby. Grab him by the face.
Oh, he bit me!
There you go. You got a weasel. Come on, kid.
And the fun doesn't end there. Every weasel hunt is topped off with a six-hour theological lecture covering both Old and New Testaments.
What is our purpose on earth? Some would suggest that our task is to please the Creator. Oh, enough of this mumbo-jumbo. Let's go looking for weasels!
Yay! Okay, there you are, son. Reach in there. Grab him. Go ahead. Grab him by the butt. Show him who's boss. Go on, get in there.
Ow, my
hand! He's a little feisty, isn't he?
Yeah. That's why they call them weasels. Come on.
It's this simple. Dave plus weasels plus the Almighty equals a joyous summer for girls and boys. Call or write for a free brochure.
All our legal problems are behind us, so visit soon.
Okay. Tomorrow on the program, Stephen Wright will be here, and we'll also have some kid inventors coming up in a couple of minutes. Nick Cave and John Crook. We'll be right back, folks.